to me, development is a very dynamic process. Just by bringing some money and, you know, some rich people come here, okay, take the money and this idea, do this, and everything will be okay. That never works. They totally mess up the traditional livelihoods and pattern of a production and consumption. So on a broader scale, I've always had doubt about the approach which relies on this kind of charitable handout as a major source for development.
The main thrust, the main strength is from the local people. Yeah. If you just hand in the money and look like we are the expert, I think those kind of projects are difficult to sustain.
We want to bring assistance to these areas that's long term and to deliver programs that are sustainable so that these villages will eventually grow and become independent of us. And it's not really an organization where we just keep handing out assistance.
I would say, you know, we are not a charitable, we always saying that we are not a charitable organization. Just we have some money and just handing the money, yeah. And when we have time and so forth, we directly go to visit the project sites and to understand the local people and work with them. It's constantly interact with the local people and do the projects together. I give you an example. For one village, the school is very random. It's just overflowed with new students. And they come to us and say, oh, okay, the school is almost fall apart, the school buildings. Can you support us to build a new school? Then they come up with a plan. And they mobilize the students and the parents to get the stone to lay the foundation of the buildings. And what Zigen do is just to pay in some of the cash for the glasses, for the nails. For those who need the cash, then Zigen pay for it. And for all those labors and the lumbers, it's local people pay for it. So really through those kind of very close cooperation with the local people and to do every project. I think this is one of the very major characteristics of the Zigen.
To me, I think one fundamental question that the participants of Zigen Fund should always bear in mind, that is to say, why do I not donate my money to, you know, say, Xiwang Gongcheng? See, if I don't donate money to Zigen Fund, I can donate money to, say, there are lots of good causes. Unless we say, look, we're doing more efficiently, we're doing something they are not doing. So that becomes one of my major concerns. I need to grapple with this. So if we want to do an organization that somehow can contribute to development of a certain communities. So eventually, I come up with a few parameters, a few points. Number one, I said, okay, we're doing some kind of a development aid. I like to characterize it as some kind of people-to-people assistance. One of our basic assumptions is that there are lots of talents and even resources in China. So if we can go there, bring ourselves physically there, try to get to know the people there, then we can form some kind of partnership. But it is not just we come here to give you money, pay the school fee. The people-to-people assistance is not a charitable handout. It is about partnership. We have our commitments, you have your commitments. One commitment is that you're going to try to let people know the importance of this thing. Try to generate more and more support to the project and try to resolve this problem. If you get this pilot project successful, this is one question that's very hot internationally. How to help retain young minority girls in school? It's not just China alone. That project itself is going to attract a lot of attention.
Hello.
只要一二三三个女的，资根基金会它主要支持的对象呢是妇女，就是女童，也就是说女学生。其中有一个很持续的、很持久的一个规律，就是说发展援助项目的资金呢，如果用到一个贫困地区的家庭当中，特别是支持妇女，那这种援助的效率就会非常高，因为在一个村庄里或在一个家庭里，如果她的妇女得到了援助，就等于说你援助了整个家庭、整个村庄，妇女对整个社会的贡献是非常大的。她们实际上是一个社会或者一个社区的一个关键的支撑。
So long, if you are from the 7 years old to 12 years old, we support all those, you know, they all come to the school after we have this scholarship program. And later, 7 years later, I interviewed one girl, she was in the junior high at that time, huh? I asked her, why do you want to go to school? I think it was very revealing, yeah. She had a book, okay? She just opened the book, yeah. And when she talked to us, she started to cry. And she said, maybe after I graduate from junior high, I couldn't find any better job, still stay in the village. But if without going to school, I cannot even read this book. Yeah, it opened up my world about what happened in the outside. Yeah, I think that's most direct, you know, for a girl. Oh, for any person, you know, I think it's their basic rights, open up their basic opportunities. So after we support this program, it was very successful. Now, all the girls in the village, they come to the school, and many of them graduate now. It's almost 30 years, you know, passed. And so now when you visit those villages, you can see every village is, you know, we support, and we have the girls, you know, all graduate from the elementary school or from junior high. And some of them not even come back as a teacher, and some of them stay village as the main active persons in the village for the village development. I think Zigen, you know, through these 14 years, get much more experiences in organization way, and also about understanding, you know, the issues in the rural development. Yeah. And for in the future, I really wish Zigen can spend more time and energy in writing, you know, articles, in doing those kind of research and follow up and summarize and experiences dissemination, promoting, you know, the understanding and about really what happened and about the different issues what happened in the rural development in China. To participate Zigen, to me, it's really learning. Yeah, I learned a lot about the rural education, about the development. Without participating in Zigen, I would not know all those things. And also through those years, I more and more respect the local people. Even they are poor, even they don't know how to read, but they have their own dignity and self-respect. And they have their own culture, and they have their own community.